16, because we just released 15 yesterday.
Yeah. All right. What are we starting with?
We just go into it. All
right. Yeah, did you add anything to the? You added shit to the stuff I sent you. No.
Nope. I told you this is gonna be open, man.
Fucking dope. Woo.
All right. You can open it whenever.
All right then. What's good? What's good? Welcome back to the podcast. This is episode 16 of Sticks and Stones podcast. We are your hostesses, your hosts.
Is that a
host and hostie?
You were cracking on me about cracking fat jokes, and now hostesses. You over talk.
Oh, I did say hostesses, didn't I? Damn, did myself in there. I didn't even realize
mistakes were made.
But yeah, episode 16. We did switch things up, so instead of releasing episodes on Friday, we're going to be releasing episodes every Monday
correct? Morning, yeah. It'll be out that Monday morning.
Dope. All right. Hell yeah.
So we're just trying some new things, seeing what works, what doesn't.
Yep. So other than that, that should be about it. Hopefully everybody's week is going fantastic. Or wait, since we're going to release this on Monday, I should say everybody's weekend was good.
Yeah, go ahead and clear your throat. I'll cover for you.
Oh, no, I'm good.
All right.
I think my voice is broken.
Oh, okay.
Ever since like last week, I had all that junk and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Hasn't been right since.
You just get a little
like
flimmy.
Somebody called, but one of the guys on my team called me at like 9 the other day. He goes, "Man, you can go ahead and get out of bed." I'm just like, "What the fuck are you talking about?" Like,
I'm working.
Been out. So yeah, I don't know. Oh well. Either way, I guess I won't be doing any singing.
No. Well, you could. You just got a raspy voice. A little country rasp.
I don't know about country. Do I sound country?
I'm not going to answer that question.
That's fucking rude, bro. I mean, you're my boy. Do I sound country?
Everybody in the comments can tell him if he sounds country.
I'm sure I do every now and then. That's all right. That's all right.
That's all right. It's all right. Now you're just overcompensating, man.
How was your past week, weekend, and whatnot?
It was good. Got a lot of the back porch awning done.
Yep.
Did some, if you follow me on IG, I did some reminiscing with some wrestling.
Hell yeah.
WrestleMania 13, a couple beers, you know, I was ready to go. Then Sunday I really didn't do much. I think I helped. I think I was working on the back porch a little bit more, but nothing much.
Yeah.
Kind of relaxed.
I think the weekend was decent weather-wise.
Yeah.
But listen, as soon as Monday hit, mm-hmm. and like it was humidity city.
Humidity city.
Humidity city.
Yeah. City.
I really am broken.
Yeah, you're over here.
It was fucked outside. That's what we'll say.
Humidity's fucked you up.
It is. But yeah, no, it's been.
You got that Florida man shit going on.
It was a pretty good weekend. Hung out.
Did you now, since we're behind a week, I guess, essentially, did you watch the Logan Paul and Mayweather fight? I know we will talk about this.
So
later,
here's the thing. I did not watch them. I waited for the highlight. I was not going to give my
hard-earned dollars.
No.
I just stole it.
No, I didn't give my hard-earned dollars to pay for that because I just don't. So what would you consider this boxing? Like, what would you consider this? Because
we'll get into it. Let's not push it yet. We'll get into that.
But
I'm just wondering if you watched
it. I just watched the highlights.
Okay.
Which is all that really mattered.
Okay, yeah. Well, that's all you needed.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, hell, there was only, like, maybe 3 good punches throughout the whole fight in 8 rounds.
Yeah.
So this one's going to be kind of loose because we want to try some things. We're not going to do good, bad, and the ugly. We're kind of could keep it more open for them, back and forth off of each other, kind of like what we were just doing. But there will be some topics. Obviously, throughout the week, things happen. But this is what we want to talk about. We brought up some good topics. And so we'll start out with this one that Corbin has found about Alex Rodriguez, or A-Rod. You know him as playing for the Texas Rangers and the Yankees and all that. But now you may know him from here on out for his men's beauty line. And by a beauty line, I mean he's wearing full-on foundation makeup.
Yeah, it's not, it ain't cologne, it ain't body wash, it ain't men's scented shit. It's makeup for dudes.
Makeup for dudes. So throughout the article, they kind of like express and kind of try to make it.
Look at all those different.
Right, like, oh, it's okay to wear like makeup as a man. And, you know, Asia's been doing it for a long time and blah, blah, blah. Look, I ain't wearing makeup.
No.
I don't give a shit.
That was going to be one of my questions to you.
I made it 34 years. I've done pretty good.
I'm
not wearing makeup.
It's not that serious. Like,
and the great thing is with the name of it.
War paint.
This isn't. So now we're trying to make it.
But it's not
masculine.
That was the only way that you was going to be able to. Like, what else would you have called it? You know what I mean? It's just, unless you're doing a movie, you're acting, you're on a TV show, whatever. I can't see any reason why, and even then, I wouldn't be a fan of it. Like, no, this is just who I am.
Right.
Whether I got a blemish on my face, a pimp, whatever the case may be, it's just, you know, I don't.
Like, why do I need to wear makeup?
I'm not putting makeup on.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, so as a kid, like, I grew up and I had pretty bad acne, but I never ever once was like, man, I'm going to wear some makeup to cover this zit.
No.
Like, so I mean, if you do, more power to you. There's nothing wrong with it. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, there's something wrong
with
it.
I'm not fucking wearing it.
I mean, there's some stuff wrong with it.
I mean, but.
Okay, maybe there's not anything. I mean, if you're being true to yourself and you want to wear makeup, like, do you. I was getting ready to start going in and hating, but you know what I mean? Do you. It's just not like. I feel like it also contradicts like how I feel on a normal basis about just being yourself.
Well, yeah, but I guess.
Or not being afraid to be yourself, I guess. Like blemishes and all that other shit.
Fair enough.
I don't know.
Fair enough.
I don't know.
Like, I don't go, like when I was dating around, I never went for the woman that wore a shit ton of makeup.
No, I'm not into all that.
Like the ones that look like they literally cake their face on. I would always call them cake faces.
Yeah. Clown paint.
Yeah.
It's
you wake up and her face is on your pillow.
Or like if you've been like making out with her and then you have makeup all over your face.
If you have a beard, that's your beard, you'd have it in your beard.
It's happened. That is a fucking turn off.
Yeah, that would be gross.
Yeah, that's happened before. Went to the bathroom after like making out with this chick and like looked in the mirror. I'm like washing my hands and I look up, I'm just like, oh Jesus. We're talking like 3 or 4 different shades of like makeup on my cheeks, some in my beard.
This isn't my color.
Yeah, this isn't. I'm like, what the hell happened here? So yeah, that's gonna be a no for me.
So you said before we started recording that he was doing this endeavor with J-Lo.
So his wife, or his ex-wife.
Well, they weren't married.
Or I mean, his ex-girlfriend J-Lo.
They were on their way to get married, but they.
Was coming out, which she's got all kinds of different. She has perfume. She's got all kinds of stuff out. Mm-hmm. Was coming out with a makeup line, and he had part of this venture with her. You know, he was already going to be coming out with this stuff, but with J-Lo.
Right. It was a joint venture. It was kind of she was ushering him to, you know, hey, go
for it. As a part of her makeup line, he was going to have one too.
Right.
But when they split, he moved forward without J-Lo. I feel like he was getting soft. Like, J-Lo was making him soft anyways. Like, there was all these TikToks, and, like, they did the light switch one where he was, like, in a dress and all that other shit.
Now here's a question. Do you think we see Ben Affleck that way with her?
Doing makeup and all that other stuff?
And TikTok?
Never happened.
You don't think you're going to see?
You hated Ben Affleck. You may see Ben Affleck. Now, here's the thing. You may see Ben Affleck.
In a TikTok.
No, but you're not going to see Ben in a dress.
No, but I don't think you're going to see him on a TikTok either.
Maybe not. If he is, he's being goofy and just being like weirdo.
She's
going to
catch him off guard. Right. But it won't be.
But
like,
he's not going to be actively participating wearing a dress, like a short cocktail skirt thing, whatever.
Was he wearing one of those?
She had on this tight mini dress.
Oh, it
thing.
Was the flip the switch one.
Yeah. And he had on a
Can
suit.
Can you find that for us, Will?
and they did the switch.
Flip the switch.
I'm just like, man.
Yeah, flip the switch, J-Lo and Alex Rodriguez.
I want to see your big ass in this dress.
So, like, he's taken many L's with her since starting dating her.
He does. It hasn't been good for him.
Obviously, the flip the switch. We'll play this for you.
J-Lo. J-Lo.
And we'll play it for you. So that you can see it. Like, he's just chilling.
He looks like a bro. I just flipped the switch.
I don't know nobody. Yeah, that's pretty whack.
Will never happen. I can't see Ben doing that.
Nah. Unless he's, like, fucking shithoused.
I still can't.
No.
I don't think
so. Then, like, we were talking about this earlier, too, that Alex Rodriguez has taken some L's.
Yeah.
And this is Anthony Edwards of the Minnesota Timberwolves. So how do they correlate? A-Rod bought a piece or a partial or half a share or whatever, half of the Timberwolves. He bought half of them or whatever, a quarter, whatever. And they were interviewing Anthony Edwards, the rookie, about the ownership switch and all this. And this is what he said.
This is not a good look.
Do you have any thoughts about him? Are you an A-Rod fan at all growing up or anything like that? What do you think about what he might bring to the team?
A fan? Who is he?
The baseball player? Alex Rodriguez?
Yeah, nah, I don't know.
He said,
okay.
Nah.
Well, I know he's going to be the owner, but I don't know nothing about baseball.
Yeah, that's, Chris, it's right now.
It's amazing
there's
to
a
me.
Letter.
He said, nah.
That a kid that played sports doesn't know.
Yeah, but how old is Ant?
He's probably 20. You would think he would know.
Well,
but I mean, if you're focused just strictly on basketball and that's
true.
All you love,
and I mean, I guess. But he wasn't playing in his era. You know what I mean?
He played probably tail end, maybe a couple of years, two, three
right.
years, like when he was like 16, 17, 18.
I mean, I don't know a ton of names in baseball myself, but I'm not a huge follower of baseball. But I mean, I know who I know who A-Rod is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I know who some
Alex
of the big
Rodriguez.
I know
it's not Anthony Rodriguez.
Or my B. I know who Alex
Another L
Rodriguez.
For you.
That is an L, sorry. I know who A-Rod is. I mean, I know who pretty much all the big names in baseball are, but there's I don't know. I could see that happening though, but it's hilarious that he's just like, "Nah, I don't who."
It's just I mean
and he owns part of the team.
Well, I guess they afterwards they ended up having a meetup. And it was just like a shake of hands, nothing like bad.
I'm sure it was a meetup just because of that.
Right, like, oh, well, shit, we need to get you to meet him because...
Because you can't keep making him look bad like
well,
this.
Right, like, I mean, how do you not know? But, again, he's young. Right. So, I don't know. It's just,
I wonder
it's
if there's
different.
Like an email sent out.
Oh, yeah, we're meeting up tomorrow.
Yeah,
either.
Man.
We're going to have photos and video and... You're going to be there, and you're going to wear some of his makeup. Wait, what?
Ooh, yeah. Yeah, I could definitely see it being hell no to that. But,
right.
Yeah. Yeah, that I think it's an interesting situation. I don't see it. I mean, around here in Ohio, the Midwest, I'm sure sales aren't going to be popping.
Maybe in Cleveland.
Not even then. East Coast, New York. I could see probably having some sales, New Yorkish area, and then like West Coast, California, and all that other stuff like that's probably where you're gonna get. You know what I mean? But
right.
You know what I mean? It's just that's a no for me. But this one is one that I found, and this is actually something I saw on somebody else's Instagram that struck me because I'm always looking for different cool stuff just that makes your brain. You know, makes your wheels turn, if you will. And it says, not everyone you disagree with is a fool. And this is very indicative of me and your relationship because we don't agree on everything. There's, you know, Germ has different interests than I do. I have different interests than Germ does. And that goes for like anybody in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to always have the same interest. You know, two brains, two modes of functioning, two modes of thinking. You're not always going to match up. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Right.
One of the things that I always say, you know, disagreeing doesn't mean disrespecting. You know what I mean? We disagree on different things.
Well,
we have varying opinions, but we're not disrespectful to each other.
everybody's grown up in different areas.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, like, just from Midwest, West, East Coast, South, whatever. That's a factor.
Mm-hmm.
Home living, you know, like middle class, lower class, right. High class, like all that shit. That matters. You got me raspy. I mean, you shouldn't have to sit there and demean each other if you don't agree. Like,
no.
There is a common ground. Yeah, you can rag on each other, but if you don't know each other,
right? If that's
that person doesn't know if you're being serious or not, that's where you kind of need to draw the line. Whereas I think most people don't know the difference anymore.
No,
or they can't handle criticism.
Or it's in a, more times than not, and you see this, and it's like, especially as of the last year and a half, with everything that's gone on. We don't have to go into detail, but over the last year and a half, you had to deal with the Black Lives Matter movement. You had to deal with an election. You had to deal with the pandemic, and through all three of those things, and I have witnessed more times than not, anytime somebody has disagreed with somebody about anything, it's a, well, I don't fuck with so-and-so anymore, or I don't talk to them, or we ain't cool, or we don't get down like that, or
right.
I cut them out of my life just because you didn't agree about a specific thing.
Right.
Whether we agree about our opinion of Black Lives Matter, and that whole movement and everything else like that. Obviously, we're all about equality and equal rights for everybody, and everybody being treated to the same standard and fairness and everything else like that as they should be. It shouldn't be any other way. But there's been different sides of a lot of different moving parts of that whole thing, obviously, and everybody feels differently about a few different parts of it. The pandemic. Everybody had disagreements about what they thought about that. And then you have the election. Obviously, people mm-hmm. felt some kind of way about, you know, well, if you're conservative and Republican, you're obviously a racist. Well, if you're, you know, left and liberal, you're obviously soft as hell and, you know.
Right.
All well, this other shit. It's
I
just,
guess the big thing is if you surround yourself around the same like-minded people.
Right.
How do you grow?
Well,
that's where, like, because you got to see everybody's, you got to see a perspective that you don't.
Right.
That's how you grow.
Absolutely.
Like, I think that's the biggest thing I learned when I was in the military was I don't know everybody's walk of life. So how do I correlate to these people? How do we work together?
Yeah.
Where, like, what do you like? You know, where are you from? Okay. You know, what kind of music do you like? Okay, I can fuck with that. Like, right. There's a silver lining and something everywhere.
Yeah.
But I think most people, if they don't agree, it's usually in like a setting where they know they'll never see that person again.
Right.
Be it online, in a parking lot.
Yeah.
Some bullshit, you know, where you know that you'll never see that person again, where you'll never have to deal with them. If you had to deal with them, you'd work with them. But most people, when you see that shit, like online, the videos and people arguing, it's most of the time somebody they don't fucking know, that they don't they know they'll never ever have to like interact with that person again.
Right.
So a lot of people, they see that one video and they think, oh fuck, there's a lot of it going on, and then there might be, but the problem is, even with that video, there's an issue there that we shouldn't even be at each other's throats
mm-hmm.
for the simple fact that I disagree with you.
Right.
Like, okay, if we disagree, so what? Like, it's not a big deal.
It is what it is.
We you like Biden, I like Trump. Right. Okay, big fucking deal. It's, who cares?
Right. And the big thing behind that is a lot of people feel, and a lot of it's driven by the media, that like, if depending on which way you vote's going to affect your life, and you got to make a decision, and it's going to affect your life and the people in your family and the people around you's life, so choose right. There's never been a time since I've been a child or an adult where whoever is in office has had a direct impact, or probably even further than that, on my life as who I am. It hasn't had an impact on how my parents, as I was a kid, provided for me as I was growing up and what I learned and didn't learn. it didn't have any effect on me as an adult and how I provided for myself and the people around me. It's never had any impact on me and how I live my day-to-day life.
Right.
I'm not saying that that's not the case for everybody. Maybe there's certain laws and bills and whatever else that were passed that directly infringes on how you live your everyday life. And if it has, I can understand that. But for me, I don't, you know what I mean? So I don't, whether somebody agrees with me politically or not is not the end all be all of my friendship or relationship with that person. That's right. Ridiculous.
Right.
I mean, I think it's just, but it's gotten to a point now where
it's beyond politics though.
Oh yeah. Well, but it's,
and that's what it used to be.
It's a divisiveness. That's not the right word.
It's divisive.
Yeah. Divisive, whatever. It's, it's so where it, everything is put out there to make people at each other's throats all the time.
Well, you know I think that's, I mean? That's your media.
And it's just, it's, well, yeah, for sure. And that's why I don't put a lot of stake in it. I don't read a lot of stuff in the media, especially as it's coming out. If there's information I want to go look up, I will search and vet all the proper sources I can to try to best educate myself on whatever I can. But I'm not, every notification I get on my phone from various BuzzFeed and whatever else news channels, I don't pay attention to. I just don't. I don't know. It's just,
well, it's hard to take in everything. I mean, it's like when you go to the store and you walk in and you have, let's say December, and you have the guy ringing the bell, mm-hmm. for the Salvation Army.
Yeah.
Hey, can I get a dollar? All right, here's a dollar. You walk into Walmart, you buy your shit, you get ready to check out, and then they're like, hey, can you give a dollar to the Children's Medical Center?
Mm-hmm.
Well, fuck, I just gave a dollar here. I give a dollar here. It's like you can only spread yourself so thin.
Well,
and there's
right.
nothing wrong with that. You shouldn't have to care about everything that's going on in the world
at
one time.
But I think the media is always trying to overfeed people whatever it can, whatever direction the money is pushing them, more times than not, I feel.
Well, it's just, I mean, they're moving the needle.
Right.
One way or the other.
Right. But yeah, that's not to get too far off topic, but that's just one of the... You could go a million different directions with this saying and everything else like that, but it was just one that caught my interest because it's, like I said, it's very indicative of how I live my life and the relationships I have with everybody around me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't have to agree with everybody on everything. People can have different viewpoints, and I still respect them for the person they are. It doesn't mean that they're any worse or any less of a person or anything like that because we don't have the same opinion or whatever the case may be. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Right.
Yeah.
Fair enough. I mean, it's hard to get people to just have a conversation or.
Oh, for sure. Because you think about it this way.
A debate or whatever you want to call it.
If you get on any, and this is something I'm off of them now. I closed the bear cave down. We done closed the bear cave down. So
okay.
I'm off of all dating sites.
Taken.
Yeah. we off of all the dating sites. So, but anyways, if you get on any dating site, it doesn't matter what it is. You could be on Bumble, Hinge, Tinder, Grindr, whatever you want, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not every single profile, but I guarantee you every single day you're going to see 70% of the profiles that you look at are going to have something that has to do with,
if you're this, then don't message me.
Exactly. If you either be down for BLM or don't message me. If you're a Trump supporter, don't message me. If you're not vaccinated, don't message me. Or swipe left, whatever the case may be. And it's just like, already
you're not vaccinated?
I swear to God, dude. So already, before even meeting this person and knowing who they are as a person, you can tell me and you can determine that through those three things that, and that's only what's going on currently in the fucking world. Because here soon, before we're out of our 30s, Trump will be dead.
Probably, yeah.
Biden will be dead. Nobody, they'll be afterthoughts.
Right?
Yeah. They'll be afterthoughts, right? Yeah. The pandemic will be an afterthought. You know what I'm saying? And we'll be on to the next whatever movement. So it's hard to see. And it's just like, God dang, man, you've really narrowed your mind down a lot. Because the person that, the reason narrows. I'm off the Bear Cave, we don't have the same, there's political views that don't line up for us.
Well, it's like a...
That's fine. I respect her for who she is and what she believes in and what she chooses, what drives her. And right. There's nothing wrong with that. And she respects my choices and what I'm interested in and all that other stuff like that. It doesn't make her any less of a person or any incapable of being the person that's for me.
Right.
So it's just hard to like, I remember when I first got on there and started seeing all that, I'm just like, damn, this is wild.
Yeah, you're narrowing yourself down already. Yeah,
this is wild because
Well, it's like the nice guy's shit. Remember when I had you get on there?
Oh, yeah. You want to talk
Reddit nice guys.
Listen, if any of you guys are on Reddit or you're not on Reddit, I highly recommend Reddit. You can literally find information or whatever on everything on Reddit, like aside to everything.
Yeah.
There's a page on there called Nice Guy, and it is a Reddit thread of nothing but beta-ness. It's just
beta.
It is wild.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
It's
brutal.
There's some, we need to get some articles off there.
Yeah,
some
different bring
threads
some.
Off there.
We'll bring
some. I don't know why I hadn't thought of that yet, but it was sad because I'm like reading some of this stuff. I'm just like, God, dog, bud, have a spine or something. Or like, there's just dudes on there crying about like girls not. I don't know. Anyways,
typical girl getting walked likes all the over. Guy who, you know, has three kids and
right.
You know,
she only wants a bad boy. Like, okay, but
blows me type shit.
Yeah, man. Nobody gives a fuck about any of that.
So. All right, we'll move on to the next article here that we
got
have.
A little deep on you there, bud.
We move over to a Newsweek article.
Hopefully this is a light one. What do you got
no,
for us?
No, it's not light.
Oh.
It's very deep and dark.
But was...
we found this a couple weeks ago. But I sent it to him, and he was like, Jesus Christ, this is
something from like a Freddy Krueger dream. Yeah, like different parts.
The
that
Conjuring.
She was, the way she was describing it, I'm just like, God dang, man.
So this lady was in her apartment.
Wait, should we tell it like? Should I tell it like this? Like,
go ahead.
So I want you guys to just clear your mind. Okay, imagine it's in the middle of the night and you're laying in bed. Okay, and you start to hear this dripping, like maybe your faucet's cracked and it's just dripping in the sink. Okay. And then you start to feel this wetness, like, okay, it's not just dripping, but there's something leaking or dripping on me or splattering, if you will. Okay. And then, okay, well, I'm awake now. It's 4 a.m. You get up out of bed. You go over. You turn the light on. And there's blood all over you, all over your bed, and all over your walls.
It's 4 a.m.
You,
it's like the devil's fucking hour, basically.
That's like...
Well, three is the...
You got PTSD from something like this.
I mean, that's something straight out of a fucking movie.
So
she woke up...
Yeah, go ahead.
She woke up and found that there was blood on her ceilings, like he said. The blood was dripping on her bed and on her.
Through the ceiling fan.
Through the ceiling fan.
It was just throwing it around the room.
And basically, they found out that her upstairs neighbor...
Yep, person lived above her.
...had died.
Natural causes, died in their apartment.
But why did they... I guess, why did you bleed, though?
The body had been decomposing for, like... Oh, so it wasn't just blood. Right. It was everything. It was all... It was
poop and...
All ugh. Them post-death juices.
Post-death juices.
You know what I mean? It was the whole...
PDJ.
It was the...
That whole PDJ, just dropping it on him.
It was all of it. PDJ.
Can I get some of that PDJ, dog?
Oh, boy.
But, yeah, they... this was in New York, right?
I believe so, yeah.
Go back up real quick. Go all the way up.
No, Texas. El Paso.
El Paso, Texas. Makes total sense.
In an apartment.
In an apartment in El Paso, Texas. Oh, it's a big ass fan.
I don't think that's it. That's outside somewhere. That's just for a picture.
Either way, that's disgusting.
But yeah, it's like, so she obviously she was freaking out, but she didn't call 911 first. She called the building manager.
Well, she probably thought maybe. I don't know. I don't know how dark.
She said there's blood on her face, on her body, on her bed. But she knew it was blood. Oh yeah.
She said it was okay.
Yeah.
Jesus. Yeah. Why are you calling the manager? She called the
building manager first. It's like, wait. I wouldn't have called. I would have called. I would call 911 right away. I'm like, somebody's been murdered upstairs. This is where I live at. I got blood. Yeah.
There's blood everywhere.
Through the floor and it's everywhere.
Ceiling.
So
his floor, my ceiling.
But the thing is, it gets worse. So the nightmare for her continues, I believe.
God, how much worse could it get?
Fixing the apartment, she got put out of her apartment.
I wouldn't move back. I'd be like, I want out.
The thing is, so she's in a lease, right?
Okay, and I don't give a shit.
If I had to guess.
That's grounds for terms of breaking the lease.
Here's the problem. Just because you're renting doesn't mean you don't need insurance. Just like you have a home and you have
homeowner's insurance. Yeah, you got to have renter's insurance.
You don't have, to.
Well, you have to prove it when you get in.
You can
prove it,
and then you can cut it if you want. True. It's important to have renter's insurance because if something like this happens, your insurance company pays to put you up in a hotel or wherever until your place is fixed.
Oh, God.
Well, she, I assume, did not have renter's insurance. She cut it. And there were no other apartments for her to stay in, so she was put out and basically homeless. Yeah, so she had to create a GoFundMe account.
Can you imagine
where she describes in the GoFundMe? I believe she describes this entire situation.
That's I'm sure she got money.
Would you have given her money?
I'm not giving anybody off of GoFundMe money. Except I have once. That was it.
Oh,
that was for a good cause. Somebody had a stroke or cancer or something happened to him.
Was it a good cause? Because yes. You don't even remember.
No, it was.
Oh, okay.
It was something around here. I don't need to talk about why I gave money. I gave like 10 bucks or 20 bucks. I'm just
messing with you. Anyways.
Oh, here it is. He found the GoFundMe. She made 17 grand.
So did they take a cut of that? Go you, dude. GoFundMe has to. How else are they going to run a business?
How much is the cut?
I'm sure it's
not
much.
She actually took photos of it. Holy shit.
As many people that are on GoFundMe, it can't be.
Oh, there's a lot. That's a lot.
There's a little bit of blood. And it's somebody else's. It's not even like you cut yourself and you bled on yourself. This is a stranger, a complete stranger's blood. Burn the whole fucking place down.
Anybody else's blood on you?
No, fuck no. Well, I've had it's happened before, but
you had a little backyard wrestling or something?
Well, so in high school, we were horse playing, and I put, you remember Nick Moore?
I remember the name, yeah. Oh, yeah. Never mind.
He played football a couple years, but mm-hmm. He was horse playing with me, and I like put him in kind of like a
sleeper.
Kind of like a standing guillotine.
Okay.
And dropped back into the locker, and it split his forehead open right here at his hairline. And he stood up. He was just like, "Oh no!" He was like, "Oh shit!" And he didn't know he was bleeding yet. And I looked at him. I was like, "Ah, shit!" And I just slapped my hand on his forehead and grabbed his shoulder. I was like, "We gotta go to the nurse." So he's bleeding down my face. He's bleeding down his face and down my hand. And I get to the nurse's office. She's like, "Well, you can't be touching his blood." And his blood's all over me now.
We're already here.
I'm just like, it's too late for that. And she was like, "Well, you gotta." I was like, "If I take my hand off his forehead, he's gonna be bleeding everywhere." I was like, "I already have his blood on me. Just do whatever you gotta do. Get something to put on this."
Right.
So she took like 5 minutes to get like gloves on and gauze because she was old. She's old as shit. But yeah, that was some. Oh man, it felt like she was taking days, but it was only a couple minutes.
Yeah.
But yeah, horse playing gone wrong. It happens. It happens a lot. It happened a lot when we were kids.
Yeah.
Me and Torin got into all kinds of stupid shit.
Musical pianos with somebody's head. You were there for that, I think.
No, I wish I was.
No, Will was, though.
Somebody bashed somebody's face on the piano?
I took somebody's head into some lockers like it was fucking a piano board.
Whose face?
Yeah, whatever. Either way.
Can I get a rhymes with?
Mac.
I already know.
Between.
Rhymes with.
Mac rhymes. Between. Anyways. All right, so we'll move on with another article or something that's happened here in the past couple days.
This is interesting to me because
obviously know who the Brooklyn Nets are. They're the Brooklyn fucking Nets.
They're the super team right
now.
Yeah,
they're, you know, KD, Kyrie,
I hope they
Harden,
get
who's injured
here soon.
But they're they're sweeping the Bucks. They
when
literally won
injured?
$30. Anyways, or by 30 points.
30 points. They won by $30.
$30, yeah. But they something interesting happened over the weekend. An article came out. And if any of you degenerates know who Lana Rhodes is, that's your problem. But
it's not. Is it a problem?
Well, not really.
I don't see it as a problem.
No,
but
she's a former adult film actress.
There you go. That was the right word because she was about
adult
to go with the other
film actress.
She is a.
But she claims she went on a date with one of the Brooklyn Nets.
Which why make this article if it was somebody that rode the bench? Nah.
No.
Especially
I don't
right
see
now.
Lana Rhodes going on a date with somebody that's riding on the bench.
Well, anybody.
Well,
on
she's a clout rider, dog.
That's true, but that's what I'm saying. So why it wouldn't matter. There's only two possibilities.
Because Kyrie just got engaged. Unless Kyrie's in an open relationship, but I highly doubt it.
Seriously doubt that.
Because that dude's all about saving the earth and shit. So
yeah. Well, we won't get into him right now. I feel like there may be something wrong with him. Anyways, she yeah, like you said, she is a clout chaser. So there's two possibilities, and
she's
both of these dudes are turds right now. I've never been a fan of either of them.
And who are these two?
You got Kevin Durant and
Slim Reaper.
James Harden.
And James the Beard Harden.
James the Beard Harden, who's a lot heftier now than he was when he was with Houston.
Nah,
he put on some weight.
He put on weight to get out of Houston.
He's also losing his hair.
Well, I mean,
but that's none of my business.
Well, he has a
Durant's losing his hair too, but that's fine too.
Durant lost his hair.
Well, even
he
though,
lost it back in like fucking Oklahoma City, dog.
They both need to get rid of that. Anyways, but the other thing is, whichever of these fine gentlemen that went out on a date with Lana Rhodes brought another female with them as a quote unquote backup. So it was a date for three.
And Lana ain't ever been put in that position, so she didn't know what to do. She was a little upset from what I could read through.
I can imagine. I mean, first off, I'm not an NBA player, so like I'm not a celebrity. I'm not
a
superstar.
NBA dudes
I'm
get
not an
like
athlete.
Top tier.
I just can't imagine that ever crossing my mind. Like, okay, well, I'm gonna go on this date with this chick. Should I have a backup like in the parking lot or inside
the
restaurant?
No. He
what
brought
I mean,
him
I'm
with
just saying,
her.
Like, should I bring a backup? I feel like it's a trashy thing to do.
Oh, for sure. I feel like it's a joke. Like
You're
one
making
of like
a mockery of this.
Well, like one of his yes men. Like, that group of them were like, you know, it'd be funny if you go out on a date with Lana Rhodes and you take a backup chick with you at
the, on
the date. It
reminds me of the movie The Girl Next Door. You remember that?
Yeah.
Where the dudes are in high school and the girl moves next door and she was like a porn star or whatever.
Yeah.
That's
great
what
movie.
It reminds me of. It's great a really movie. Good movie. It's on Netflix now. So
it's a great movie. Have you watched
it? There
you
go. Of course I've watched it.
Okay. If you don't fuck her for me, then I'm going to kill myself.
I'm going to kill myself, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's. I feel like it was a joke. Like, it was a setup joke, inside joke that we don't get, but maybe.
I don't even know if it's a joke as much as it is, like, they just, whoever the person is, thinks that they're just so upper echelon, they're just the shit that they can just.
All right. Who do you think it was?
I think it was
though?
KD, because she KD? Also had some comments about the person on the date. Like, she was trying to make conversation. She was trying to
asking
ask questions
him,
like, and all
yeah,
this
I'm
other
into
shit
this,
like
I'm into
that.
I'm into that. And he was like, I ain't into anything.
I don't have any interest. I'm not into anything.
Like, I basically, she said she had to say, like, this isn't for me. Like,
Harden likes Taco Bell too much to not have an opinion.
God dang. like,
nah, that just, man loves Taco Bell.
Basically, dude. That this person wasn't spicy enough is what she said.
Yeah, she literally
she said they weren't interesting. They weren't spicy. They didn't have anything to talk about. Like, no ability to conversate or anything like that. So, look at that boy. Thank you,
yeah,
Wig.
But he
thank
was,
you, dude. Wig. This so, looks like
no,
somebody's
no, hang on.
Grandpa.
Yeah, but he was wearing a suit, they think.
Nah.
No, they really do, because now go to the other photo in Brooklyn. They really think he was wearing a weight suit. Not to change subject here. I also thought it was Katie.
Tell me
well.
That don't look like somebody's uncle.
Oh, I agree.
This is hilarious.
But I think, I truly think, because look at the picture right there in the green, with the outline green to the left, right there. He's in Brooklyn right there. How yeah, the fuck true. Do you lose that much weight
but
that
look
quick?
At him there.
Right, that's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like
that's
something's
so,
not right here.
That's
man.
So funny, though. But how are you going to have a weight suit? That's like one of them athletic shirts.
Dude, I understand.
I don't know.
He could have a suit.
You might him. Be right.
He could have like a little beater suit.
That's true. Because there, well, yeah, because there he is before the weight suit with just right. that tank on.
I mean, he was always kind of, he always looks hefty because his beard and just his body. They put a fucking Mark Henry.
That's
have you seen
up.
Him lately?
No.
He lost a bunch of weight.
I can imagine if he wants to live past 60, he probably needed to.
Yeah, he needed to. Either way, I think it was Katie as well because Katie just seems bitch made like that.
He is, dude. He's trash. The shit he had going on with Rappaport, which I don't agree with either side because Rappaport's a clown. But it was indicative of both their attitudes.
That shit I mean? Rappaport was saying about Katie's knees, though.
Yeah, that was messed up.
Anyway.
Rappaport's a really good. He's good at trolling, but he's just gotten a little bit too big for himself, and I can't fuck with him anymore.
Right.
The shit that he says.
Even
just,
Brendan Schaub got in his ass and was like, "So yeah, well, what do you do now?"
Brendan Schaub's also a
why?
Chaser.
That's what I said.
Yeah.
Chill. All right. I think.
But what? So, but I had talked about this.
We talked about the Mayweather fight.
No.
Okay.
So we're gonna start doing. 2 weeks ago, we talked about Demi Lovato, and we're not gonna start talking about her again because I could go on for days. Mm-hmm. I claim her as. Demi Lovato is a fucking dumpster fire.
Yes,
she was that episode's dumpster fire. So I'm gonna go ahead and say that this week's episode 16, Whoa. That KD and Harden are this week's dumpster fires.
Dumpster fire of the week.
Because until I know which one it is,
we'll know next week. Probably.
I'm sure either of them could be this week's dumpster fire.
Yeah.
So that's something I think we're gonna start doing.
Dumpster fire
yeah,
of the
like
week.
Yeah, like kind of like donkey of the day on the breakfast show or whatever.
That's fine. Dumpster
or sick
fire
fuck
of the
week
works
week.
For me.
Yeah.
Fuck that sick fuck of the week shit.
Dumpster fire.
Dumpster fire of the week. 2020, because that was a dumpster fire.
Yep.
We will do that from here on out. But I asked you earlier in the episode about the Mayweather fucking Jake Paul fight.
Yes.
You said you didn't buy it, which no. I didn't buy it either, but I did the same thing. I was on Bleacher Report.
Right.
I found it just more comical.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, Chad Johnson or Chad Ochocinco fighting.
Which, that one, I mean.
I heard that he was handling him the whole fight and then got knocked down.
Yeah, because Chad had, from what I could tell from some highlights, Chad had got some pretty good hits in, too. Like, right. He landed some pretty good shots.
Okay.
So, I mean, I felt like that fight was. That was probably one of the more entertaining. I know for sure the Chad Johnson fight was more entertaining than the main bout.
Right. No, they even
without
said
a
that.
Doubt.
They said, and then I saw the video of Mayweather apparently knocking out Paul and then catching him.
I watched
him.
That probably like 30 times.
Your brother sent it to
and
us.
And you can clearly.
It was a late delay knockout, but he was out on his
he
feet.
He clipped him good. Because yeah. This is what may I we'll get into this in a second, but he clipped him good, and you can see, like you can see him, like you can
stagger.
See the muscles in his back.
Well,
you can because you're looking at the camera angle of Floyd from the back, and you can see him straining and everything to hold him up.
Right. Hit it.
This is fucking annoying. I don't know why you people are watching this shit anymore.
Yeah, I agree.
It's the point has been made. You've seen all you need to see. Move on.
It's not a frantic pace. He's putting pressure with the feet. Right there, that hit, and then they say that it's where he was out. Right there.
Did you see that?
Yeah. Oh, it was a quick, clip.
You noticed they did that. Somebody had called it to me.
They put the red X, X marker on him.
It was...
He's like, all right, stand up, dog, stand up. Blop.
What the fuck was that?
Because that's not how you hold when you go in with boxing. Not that I'm a boxer. Typically, when you tie up with somebody and you're hugging them, you're not like you're not bent over at the waist.
No, you're not like
you're hugged up with them right. with your arms
how,
around
as,
them.
As much as the height difference there was, when he went to clinch the whole rest of the fight, he never did that.
This was nothing but a ploy.
It was entertainment.
To get you fools money.
Entertainment.
Because there's not any universe, not this one or wherever the fuck Elon Musk is from, where Logan Paul, a YouTube sensation, or any other person that didn't spend their entire life in boxing comes into boxing to box the best boxer in the world and wins. Mm-hmm. It's just not going to happen.
It was an entertainment purpose, but... I think we're in this weird time era where most people want to see that for some reason.
Right. So what does money has to work harder at making shit more entertaining than he does at doing anything else. He didn't train for this fight. Mm-hmm. He hasn't trained for the last two.
Well, who?
He didn't train for McGregor.
Oh, you're talking about? Oh, no. Yeah. No.
So
they said that he looks heavier, which I mean,
He doesn't need to.
No, he doesn't need to.
I don't.
It's all he can rely on his
on speed
skill.
Alone and instinct alone.
And he only will. He probably walks around at 150 something.
Yeah.
So he only loses like 8 pounds to get in his division when he did fight.
Right. It's not entertaining to me personally. It's not entertaining because what are you fighting for? You're not boxing within a weight bracket.
Right. There's no judges.
There's no tournament. There's no ranking. There's no judges. Nobody's knocking anybody out because if this wouldn't have went past the first round, if that was the case.
Well, he did knock him out, but he kept him up.
I mean.
He held him up.
Right. I mean, actual, because if he would have went out there first round and went to work like
he. I know what you're saying.
You know what I mean?
Right. It's just where's like he fight? Said, he carried Mayweather around for a few rounds.
So it's just not entertaining to me. I just...
The Mayweather one was, and I'm sorry.
The Chad Johnson one?
No, McGregor. Mayweather-McGregor, that was entertaining because they're both real fighters.
Right.
So I can understand, like, okay, I'll tune in for that.
Mm-hmm.
But these two... Nah, I ain't about it. I don't care.
Because
you're a YouTuber. You're out for money. That's the whole point. I understand that. That's great. If you get it, cool. You're not getting it from me.
I want to know how long people are going to continue to give their money to stuff like this because, in my opinion, I don't see it having a very long shelf life as far as, like, it's not sustainable. Like, how long are you going to just watch these? All this was sparring.
I was just on my phone before we started the episode, and Amanda Nunes... literally put out a Instagram picture of her and Kim Kardashian.
That'll never happen.
And Amanda Nunes said, let's make it happen.
It's
never going to happen because Kim Kardashian's not about that life.
No.
But can you imagine if they actually did? That money would be through the
I'd
roof.
I'd be so against it.
Oh, I wouldn't watch it. But so there would be people to watch it.
There would be.
Because people want to see Kim Kardashian get knocked the fuck out. That's the only reason.
Exactly. But it's just...
That's where we're at.
It's becoming more of a spectacle than the actual sport of boxing.
Yeah. We take all of the hard work out and just put the spectacle in it.
And that's one of the things that, like, okay, so we listen to Fighter and the Kid. We listen to The King and the Sting and stuff like that. And Shab fancies himself an expert on all things fighting.
Sure.
Okay. I'm
if you watch any of his previous fights, I would say otherwise, but whatever.
Riggs, yeah, for real. I've reached about the max that I can hear from him when it comes to fighting, because it's just he is to the point now where he is getting money to push and publicize
a certain
agenda is going on with these fights.
Right.
Okay, so now he's talking about he's talking about Jake Paul. Logan's younger brother.
Believe it. Oh, yeah.
Well, people should believe in him. And, well, this is just his path right now. It's not his path for him to be fighting a professional boxer. And he's going to be a professional boxer, but why would he be in there fighting professional boxers? He's just not there yet.
Right. Like, one of them is a former amateur Golden Gloves boxer.
That's Jake.
Right. Which I can, that's fine. Cool. I respect that. Now, that doesn't make you a professional.
No.
But, I mean, so, cool.
The only reason he's not boxed anybody.
Right, right. And I get it. And he just went straight to the top.
His thing is going to be the same thing as Logan. It's just he's not fighting Mayweather.
Right.
He's fighting these has-beens that he's actually fighting, and it's still not worth anything.
Well, the Woodley fight is an actual pretty dangerous fight.
That'll be the first
fight.
One. That, right. But it, none that of is it's when. None of, you can't even put any of this on a record.
No, but I think Woodley's not no pushover, and I think Woodley's going to probably whip his ass.
Right. He's not going to knock. He's not going to knock Woodley out.
No, I don't think he's going to knock Woodley out.
But it's just tough to, I don't know. It's hard for me to get behind, because here's the thing. Like, you're about that life from what you're saying, which I know is a show to get people's hype. That's fine.
Mm-hmm.
It's not, but whatever. Fight a real boxer. You're a boxer, fight a real boxer. You want to be a professional boxer,
right.
Fight a professional boxer.
Right.
Well, start at the bottom of the... Nobody's saying, okay, so I would I would love for you to get in the ring with Tommy Fury. Okay, maybe you're not there yet. Start at the bottom. Who is the last person at the bottom of that weight class?
Well, that or either an amateur. Just start out amateur.
Start with that.
But
just like any other regular
that.
Person.
He ain't going to do that.
But that's the thing that annoyed me about Shab. Just like, well, that's not his path to be fighting any actual boxers right now. Well, how else do you get in to be a professional boxer?
Well, his path is that.
Exactly.
That's what
same as Shab's money. So what's... it's just...
Well, Shab got out of the game because he saw he made more money, or it was easier to make decent money on YouTube and
well,
all this other
shit. And it's just... over the last year, it's just been nonstop.
Oh, it's been
slowly a
slippery slope.
Yeah.
When he gives Theo a bunch of shit for basically chasing Twitter comments to get on the UFC fights every weekend.
Yeah.
Bitch, shut up. Like,
he does the same. So Theo shoots.
Well, he don't do the same thing, because he says he's like intensely watching. Whatever.
Which is nonsense.
That's bullshit. Who cares? Either way, fuck him.
Yeah.
This weekend, or since this will be on Monday, the UFC fights will be done and over with. Adesanya and I forget the name of the dude, the Italian dude that's fighting. They're fighting this weekend. There's
pull
three.
Up that card.
I think there's three. UFC 263. That's you were at the top there. Yeah. We've got Adesanya and Vettori 2, right. And Vettori, that was a pretty close fight, the first one.
Adesanya is such a beast.
We got another championship fight, and then we have Nate Diaz coming back to fight a pretty...
Didn't his last fight get canceled?
I think so.
I think, yeah, because of his... He got an injury or something like that, right?
Something happened to one of the two. I don't think it was Nate, though.
I thought it was.
I don't know.
Maybe. Not sure.
But, yeah, I mean, we're coming closer to the McGregor-Poirier fight. That's in July.
I think that'll be interesting.
That'll be a good fight. If Conor loses, I think he's done. But that's we're way down the line. I think he's done.
There's
Where's
not
the draw?
Really any reason. If you're Conor McGregor, there's not really any reason to be getting into the ring with somebody to fight.
Right. So
you done made it.
I mean, he's making money off of that. All that scotch.
He's made more money off the UFC. He's made,
McGregor clothing
he's made
line.
More money as a UFC fighter than anybody else has, just as a UFC fighter. Like, I'm talking getting paid, because he demanded to get paid by
the
UFC.
Mayweather fight, he basically swindled.
Right. But I mean, as far as
UFC got a cut of that,
Dana paying that man, he's I would assume that he's been the highest paid UFC fighter by the UFC to date. Now, on top of that, he also has a liquor company that is booming.
Yeah. He was the most highest paid athlete this year.
Yeah.
I think it was, is it 2 years in a row? Or mm-hmm. just, I don't know. Either way, close. I know it was this year for sure. He was the highest paid athlete.
He gets money from all kinds of different sources. He has a special, it's not a documentary, is it? Would it be a documentary, a self-doc or whatever they call it?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. He makes money off of that from different platforms. He makes money from his likeness on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. I mean, the money is pouring in.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely by far the highest paid.
Best double champ we've ever had.
I mean, I would agree.
And hands down the funniest.
Yeah.
Hands down the funniest. I think he's
a character. Oh, he's a character. I mean, that's what draws a lot of people.
But yeah, Adesanya is never anything. He is nothing but entertainment.
Yeah. So, I mean, that'll be happening. That'll be already done and happened, but this will be out on Monday. So, hopefully, you guys had a great weekend. Hopefully, the fights are good. And hopefully, the NBA playoffs are.
Where's our agenda at, Wick?
Good. I don't think there's anything left. I don't think so. We talked about everything. Yeah.
What's that last two?
That's the videos for the KD stuff. Or no, not the videos, but the just the, yeah, but, you know, we'll have an answer to which little bitch boy it was.
Yeah, that'll be interesting for sure. I don't know. I don't know. I think it's going to be KD.
I'm pretty sure it is, too.
I don't know how anybody likes him.
He wasn't spicy enough, so.
Yeah. He's definitely not spicy. But
yeah.
He looks like an alien to me.
Well, I mean, he's 7 foot. But yeah, we'll see you guys next week on the pod. And that will be episode 17.
17.
Hopefully we'll have a little bill. 20. Yeah, 20. You want to do something big, you said. So
hell yeah.
We'll see what happens. 20
will be falling somewhere around 4th of July.
That's true.
So,
yeah,
get your America on.
So, we'll see you guys next week, and we'll enjoy you. We'll enjoy our weekend.
Hell yeah! As always, thank you for listening, watching, liking, mm-hmm. subscribing,
continue
commenting, whatever it is that you do,
buying, all that stuff.
We appreciate it. We're happy to be entertaining. So.
Mm-hmm. So you guys have a good weekend. We'll see you next Monday.
That's it.
And peace.
Peace.
What was that at?